I'd like to just cite from the official citation in its preamble. For acts of gallantry at the risk of his life above and beyond the call of duty. I want to just unpack that statement briefly. To act with gallantry is to act with courage. But courage doesn't mean you aren't afraid. It just means you go into harm's way anyway. And the danger that Captain Swenson faced that day was not some generalized risk of injury. It was a threat of imminent death. And Captain Swenson acted above and beyond the call of duty. No one ordered him to repeatedly place himself at the threshold of death to save his brethren. No one would have judged him disloyal for not going in a second, a third, a fourth time into mortal peril. We honor Captain Swenson today, not only for the offering of his life to his comrades, which is the most noble thing a man or woman can do in this life, but also because we want that that bravery to be passed on to the next generation. What we honor, we elevate, and we want our children to emulate. My two sons serving the U.S. Army entered the military at a time of war in large part because of men like Colonel, like Captain Swenson. Captain Swenson represents also the countless acts of heroism of men and women that can't be here today, whose great acts of bravery go uncounted. So for their sake, as well as for the act of bravery that we read about just a few moments ago, I want to thank you, Captain Swenson. You're a great encouragement to me, and I know to the other members of this body. And I want to thank you for laying your life down for your friends and for our liberty.
Raise that mic up a little bit. Lieutenant Governor, Senator O'Bann, members of the Senate, first off, thank you very much for having me out here today. Washington State, as I continually have to remind some East Coasters, is Washington State. This is my home. This is where my heart is. This is what I fight for. You take care of it. And now I sit in a room with people who share a very similar trait to my own. I'm beginning to like to hear myself talk. In all seriousness, my battle ended several years ago, but my responsibilities do carry on. My responsibilities are to carry on the memories of my fallen colleagues, to carry on the responsibility of reminding the American people that we still have service members downrange, and to remind the American people that we have veterans who are home, but their battles continue. But you sitting in this body have a responsibility to those veterans and those service members as well that reside in Washington State. And I ask you to always remember that as you sit here in this room, that some of our members have come home and still need continued help. So I'll do my part to remind Washington State and the American people of what their responsibility is to our veterans and our service members, but I ask you to continue doing the same. So again, thank you for having me here today. Thank you for giving me the chance to talk, and this is really a privilege. Thank you.